Darrin, I'll be honest with you. I haven't been doing too well with Braddock. He's a little younger than I am. The athletic type. So I think you two would hit it off a lot better. That's the only reason I wanted you to handle it. So will you take a couple of hours and think about it?
A mogul, a magnet, a ruthless big deal. Ambition and power is what you now feel.
Wait a minute, Larry. I've just thought it over. I'll take it.
You will? How come you changed your mind?
Because you asked me to. Because it's an important account. Because you are my chief. And because of the raise.
Raise? What raise?
Larry.
Oh, that raise. We'll talk about it.
Talk is cheap. My raise won't be.
We'll talk about it when we see how you hit it off with Braddock. I have a lunch date with him today. And you're invited.
I'll be there with bells on.
Just come as you are.
Betty, bring in the file on the Braddock account. And while you're at it, bring in the personal folder on Braddock himself.
It's too bad you didn't see that fight last night, Tate. It was a beauty. Champ just kept jabbing away and jabbing away, and then, boom, a left hook, and it was all over. How come you missed it? I thought you told me you were a fight fan.
Oh, I am, I am. But at the time, I was attending a much more important fight with my wife.
What?
It was a draw. Oh, there he is.
Yes, sir, leave it to me.
Looks like a nice chap. Clean cut, fit.
Oh, they don't come any cleaner cut or fitter.
I like that. Braddock Sporting Goods likes to use men who look like they use their products. Yes, sir. Fitness counts.
Darrin Stephens, this is Bob Braddock.
Mr. Braddock?
Hi.
Good to meet you.
Thank you.
Sorry I'm late, but Jim, you know.
Jim who?
Larry, I told you I was going to work out of the gym before lunch.
Oh, that Jim. Sure.
As I always say, mens sana in corpore sano.
That's funny. That's always been my motto.
Is that right?
Terrific motto. Mens sana in...
in corpore sano. A healthy mind and a healthy body.
Oh, that is terrific. How about a cocktail?
In the middle of the day? You know me better than that, Larry.
Isn't that interesting? You know, I'll bet you and me are the only two men I know who don't drink in the afternoon.
Make that three men.
You know, you look so familiar, Mr. Braddock. Missouri, 53.
Oh, no. Wisconsin, 47.
Hey, let me guess. Basketball.
Track. Ran the 100.
No kidding. So did I.
What was your time?
What was yours?
10-2.
Mine was 10-3.
Beat you.
Excuse me, Mr. Tate. There's a telephone call for you.
Oh, be right back.
He's a nice guy.
Larry? No, he's a prince. The thing I like most about him is he's not a credit grabber. If we score with a client, he doesn't hesitate to say that I was responsible. You know, Mr. Braddock?
Bob.
Hmm. In my opinion, Larry Tate's one of the best executives I've ever known.
Well, a good executive is one who surrounds himself with top talent.
Oh, thank you. Well, Larry's the main reason I stay at McMahon and Tate. There's no greater satisfaction in the world than being needed.
You know, you're quite a guy yourself, Stevens. I'm surprised Tate doesn't make you a partner.
Well, I'm satisfied just to do the work and let Larry reap the benefit.
That's strange. When I got to the phone, no one was on it.
Don't worry about that. You left me in very good hands.
McMahon and Tate has the best hands in the business.
You mean you hire the best hands in the business?
Serena, what's this about Boyce and Hart? I am here on a mission of mercy. They were rude to me.
I'm going to hate myself for asking, but when did you see Boyce and Hart?
Just now. I asked them to entertain at the Cosmos Cotillion, and their manager kicked me out.
You asked them to entertain at the Cosmos Cotillion?
Yes.
What's a Cosmos Cotillion?
Well, it's sort of a dinner dance.
Oh. Sam, would you sort of get her out of here?
I'll try. Oh, that's the thanks I get for being sweet.
Sure. The original Miss Nice Guy.
Would you rather I handle this in my own way? Or would you prefer to be the hero and tell them that you will not use them on your television show unless they sing my song at my cotillion?
Sam, will you do something before I say something?
It's called I'll Blow You a Kiss in the Wind. A little guitar, a little atmosphere, and it wails like this. Wherever you are tonight, a feeling tells me that you look out of sight. So I'm gonna blow you a kiss.
I'll give you an unbiased opinion. It stinks. Thanks.
You're welcome. Cousin, may I please speak to you in private?
Certainly. Are you going to make What's-His-Face disappear, or shall I?
Neither. We will disappear. Back in a minute, sweetheart.
Care for a midnight snack?
No. Want to hear more of my song? Or do you think it stinks too?
Serena, I think it's terrific. I think it's so terrific it's too good for mortals. So why don't you sing it yourself at the cotillion?
Because the lyric cries for a male vocalist or a male group.
Do yourself a favor. Try and find a couple of guys who aren't quite as popular as Boyce and Hart.
Say, there's an idea.
Then I've been of some help, right?
Right. Which rhymes with good night. Wrong. Which rhymes with my song, which the group of my choice is going to sing at my cotillion. I am going to make them so unpopular they'll be desperate to sing anywhere. As the trumpets blare, let all ears smart. Failures both be voice and heart.
Oh!
Hey, troops, what are we waiting for?
That's right. Who wants to see a couple of bums like Boyce and Hart?
Yeah!